We've been in India for a few days now, and I'm happy to say that our visit is off to a great start. As I mentioned on Monday, one of the goals of this trip is to pursue economic opportunities that will create jobs, grow the economy, and benefit Canadians and their families. India is one of the fastest growing economies in the world.
How quickly things change. That was Justin Trudeau speaking from India on Wednesday. He was just facing a few international problems, but now he's on much shakier ground after an attempted murderer, an Indian separatist, was invited to a formal reception with the Canadian delegation. There was a photo of the man with Sophie Gregoire Trudeau being shown over and over and over again in Indian media. Canadian media resorted to shouting questions at the Prime Minister across a cricket pitch. So, we thought we'd get at issue together to talk about this and a little bit more. We may get to Patrick Brown as well if they don't get too crazy here with the India stuff. Andrew Coyne is in Toronto tonight, and so is Chantal Hébert. And Paul Wells is with me in Ottawa, just down the hall from me. Okay, Chantal, why don't you start us off? At this point, has anything good come out of the India trip? Was any of it worth it, given the various things that have happened over the past number of days?
This has probably been Prime Minister Trudeau's worst trip. Possibly some good will come out of it, although we're not going to see any signs of it anytime soon. And he has provided enough pictures and enough problems that it will likely stick to him.
What do you think, Andrew?
If there were any, the Atwal affair, this invitation to the dinner with the Prime Minister in attendance, would have undone it. It is frankly baffling. You go through the list. There's no way the High Commission would have invited him if they'd known his background. There's no way they would not have known his background. There's no way they would have taken the say-so of an obscure Liberal backbench MP, which is the storyline we're being fed, to do it. So you're left with that this list would have gone through the Prime Minister's office, as anybody who knows about these things would tell you. And again, it's impossible they would not known about his background. And sadly, it is possible they might have invited him knowing. When you look at how they palled around with him and his ilk, with extremist fringes within that group, it is really troubling, raises really troubling questions. It's really hard to find an innocent explanation for it.
So although they say that the RCMP didn't screen the list, typically doesn't screen the list, these are just people that are gathered at things. We know the Prime Minister does lots of town halls where there's hundreds of people. Go ahead, Paul.
All you have to do is Google his name, and you would find two stories from Kim Boland of the Vancouver Sun expressing similar shock and dismay when he showed up at the provincial Liberal throne speech in 2012 and when he showed up on a federal Liberal riding association organizational chart in the same year. Every time Mr. Atwal appears in the context of Liberal politics, there's a story in the Vancouver Sun saying, how did this happen? At some point, Liberals might start to ask themselves the same question.
So is it, are we concerned here that Canada is being perceived in the very way that we didn't want, and that is, you know, he went over there to deliver a message that Canada was behind a united India, or are we concerned that there's been a security breach, or where are we at with that, Chantal?
We're concerned about incompetence. To put it bluntly, yes, we can go into mega politics and stuff, but the first issue is incompetence. That MP, unless he's totally disconnected, had to know who that person was. And beyond that, the Google thing would have told anyone who was screening who was going there. So bottom line, the only question is who in the hell is running the shop.
I'm left hoping it's incompetence. You know, of all the mistakes to make with all of the people in all the places at all the times, to go on a trip to India whose purpose, avowed purpose, was fence mending and allaying what appeared to be very justified fears on the part of the Indian government that the Liberal government here is soft on Sikh terrorism and Sikh separatism, to go and to somehow, for the mistake, that's what it is, for it to be this mistake, to choose this guy to invite to that event, it's just incomprehensible.
Paul, I mean, the Prime Minister can't be expected to know who all these people are, but he obviously has to wear this to some extent. So who could be responsible? Who should have to wear this, other than the Liberal MP who, I don't know, I find it hard to believe that it's just his word that gets a guy in the door.
Well, apparently no one's responsible after 10 minutes. The MP put out a tweet apologizing, and that appears to be the end of that. But you know what? Take this whole affair of Mr. Atwal, the convicted attempted murderer, off the table. I'm still not entirely sure what the point of this trip was. Nature abhors a vacuum, but trouble loves one, and trouble got sucked into the vacuum of the rationale for this trip. The Prime Minister likes to try and attract investment to Canada from places where there's investors interested in finding a place to put their buck. But he spent all of half a day in one room greeting a succession of CEOs for photo ops and for chats of, you know, several minutes or 20 minutes or a half hour at a time, rather than, if he was really interested in investment, going to where they make their product, going to their offices to see their work, going to an empty field in India that could be some fantastic development if Bombardier or some other Canadian company wanted to do that. Yeah. If this was a trade promotion tour, it was the lousiest one I've seen. If it was a cultural tour, he hasn't been to any cultural site that he could not have visited in 1920. Modern India is absent from this trip. It's an astonishing kind of random stroll for this Prime Minister and his family.
Go ahead, Chantal.
I have one answer to that, and it's two words, Jagmeet Singh. And they attempt to showcase this trip as a showcase for how much power Sikh Canadians have within the Liberal Party. And a betrayal in public of the concern that Liberals may have about losing votes in some specific areas of the country, and trying to fend that off with that trip. A lot of planning has to have gone into that trip. You don't get these this clothing that is, you know, for the kids and stuff like that. Though I don't think you pick it up at the equivalent of a Kmart in India, seriously.
No.
So this was showcased as a spectacle, and it's been a spectacle that failed.
And that may explain Atwell's presence at that dinner. I mean, remember, it's fine for both parties to want to appeal to votes within the Sikh community. That's fair game. What both parties, however, have been willing to do is to dally with some of the more extreme elements within that community. It's not so long ago, of course, that we had Jagmeet Singh refusing to answer a very straightforward question to denounce the people who were glorifying the mastermind of the Air India bombing. So you've got both of these parties, both of these leaders, playing fast and loose with that kind of explosive material, and no kidding, the government of India is going to be concerned about that.